NorthJerseySports.com Athlete of the Week. You can nominate an athlete by tweeting at us, hashtag NJSAOTW, or emailing us at NJSAOTW@gmail.com.
This is the NorthJerseySports.com Athlete of the Week. This week's Athlete of the Week, Riverdale's Rachel Sorkin. Rachel, congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, what a week for you, Rach. I mean, starts out with a win over Old Tappan, two goals in that win. Talk about that game a little bit.
Well, at the beginning of the game, we were coming out really slow. They obviously got a really lucky goal. It kind of brought us down a bit, but going into halftime, our coaches pumped us up. I mean, 1-0 at halftime. It's anyone's game, so I mean, I gave it my all. I know the rest of the team did. We got the first goal. It was 1-1. From there, everyone stepped up even more. So we were playing at like our highest level, and it's another goal and came out on top.
Yeah, came out with a win.
Yep.
And then you face IHA on Sunday in the Bergen County quarterfinals. IHA goes up quickly, 1-0. You personally, you had a chance in the first couple seconds, whiffed on it a little bit, and then all of a sudden, I mean, you were barely getting any touches on the ball. Talk about how frustrating that was for you.
I was frustrated. I mean, in games like that, like, I know I'm not going to have, like, the ball all the time. I know I'm going to get limited chances, so I have to bury them. But obviously, the first one, I didn't. I mean, when halftime came, we were down 1-0. It was the same as Old Tappan. So, I mean, no one let down. We knew we still had a chance because last week, obviously, we came on top. So I just gave it my all in the second half because we had nothing to lose then.
Down 1-0, 19:02 to go. You scored a tie it on a laser from 35 yards out. Talk about how you saw that play happen.
I mean, I just got the ball. I saw the goal. I went over to Coach Axley, and he's like, the goalie's off her line. So I was like, okay. So I took a touch inside. I mean, I remembered him saying the goalie's off her line, so I just ripped the shot. I mean, I hope for the best. I mean, it went in. Someone could have gotten a rebound or anything could have happened. So
when you tied the game, talk about it seemed like there was an instant transformation, not only within you, but within the team as well. And everyone stepped it up, kind of having that belief, like, hey, you know, we can win this game. We're not just playing to kind of hang around and see what happens.
I mean, the same thing happened at Old Tappan. It was 1-1. And then from there, everyone stepped up. So, I mean, I had hope that everyone would step up again. I mean, we were putting high pressure on them. They kind of got a little frantic, I guess. And then we scored again. I've never been so happy. So it was awesome.
On that game winner with 1:57 to go, I mean, you were marked so tightly the entire game, and all of a sudden, their back line kind of creeps up. Julie McGovern pops in over the top, and all of a sudden, you go from being marked tightly to having no one within 10 yards of you. Had a tough first touch there, but
I know what I was thinking.
But, you know, what was going through your mind? Could you believe that you were so open?
I knew Julie was going to play to me, so I kind of checked away a bit, so I had that space to run into. I mean, my first touch was awful. I didn't think I was going to get like back on the ball, but it was on my left foot. I mean, I'm not the best with my left foot, but I just slid it across back post, and it happened.
Yeah, and as you're laying on the ground, defenders, you know, sliding there, the goalie's right next to you. I mean, talk about, did you know it was going in as soon as you left your foot?
I could see it going in, but when the goalie got a hand on it, I got a little nervous, but then I saw it roll into the goal, and I was ecstatic. It was awesome.
All right, and now the big four questions for Rachel Sorkin. First of all, talk about how big of a win this is for your program.
It's huge. I mean, we've played IHA my sophomore year. We lost. I mean, we've never gone, well, at least I haven't in my 4 years, gone to play at home, like a big game like this, so that's awesome. So I'm really excited about that.
Yeah, playing at home in the Bergen County semifinals. Second question, you get Ridgewood in the semifinals. Is there anything different going into that matchup, or are you thinking, we're playing with house money now, let's just keep doing what we're doing?
I mean, I think we're going to keep doing what we're doing. I mean, we played Ridgewood a few weeks ago, one of our star backs, Madeline Weber, was out because stitches in her eye, so we didn't have her. I mean, we kind of gave them opportunities that we shouldn't have. Our defense broke down, but I think if we play like we did against IHA and Old Tappan, we'll come out with the right result.
Third question, missed your entire junior year with a leg injury. Talk about how difficult it was for you, and what was the toughest part about the rehab to come back?
I mean, it was tough because I'm really active. I always want to be moving everything. I mean, when they told me, obviously, you're not going to be able to jump right into everything, it was hard because I usually do that. I'm not patient at all. I mean, rehab was hard. I mean, like I said, I couldn't even press the leg press. Like, I was nervous to do anything, but I just stayed positive, and now I'm here, and it's awesome. I feel 100%. I never felt like I broke my leg or anything.
Last question, heading to the University of Miami next year. You know, great program down there. What was it about Miami that made you choose them?
Honestly, everything. I mean, right when I stepped on campus the first time I ever visited, I just fell in love. I mean, the staff, everyone, like the coaches, the staff, the players, everyone just like made me feel at home. I mean, the coaches want you to succeed in the classroom and on the field, so I thought that was awesome. They're great at soccer and in, like, their academics are awesome, so I really think I can do great things there.
All right, NorthJerseySports.com Athlete of the Week, Rachel Sorkin. Rachel, thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you.